Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to add annotations to nodes and connectors in the Angular diagram component. You will learn how to customize the annotation alignments. Additionally, I will show you how to modify the appearance of annotations using text wrapping and font styles. First, I open an existing Angular application, where I added a diagram component that renders a simple flowchart to check whether a number is even or odd, with pre-created nodes and connectors for designing the flowchart. To learn more about integrating the diagram component into an Angular application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application using the command ng-serve. The diagram canvas renders with the specified flowchart. You can add the annotation by double-clicking the node. Now, I will demonstrate how to add annotations to nodes programmatically. To the first node, I add the eNode annotations tag to define the annotation collection. And in it, add eNode annotation tag to define a single annotation. And set the content to start. Here, the content property displays the specified text in the node. Looking at the first node now, it is rendered with the content start. Similarly, I add annotations to the other nodes with the appropriate content. Look, all the nodes in the flowchart have annotations. Next, I will show you how to add an annotation to a fifth node dynamically on a button click. First, I comment out these annotation-related codes in the fifth node. Here, I am going to use the Syncfusion Angular button component. So, I install the Syncfusion Angular buttons package by running the command ng-add Syncfusion ej2 Angular buttons. In the app module file, you can see the button module is automatically imported from the Syncfusion ej2 Angular buttons package and injected into the imports array of ng module. And add the button component by defining the ejs button attribute with the button content add annotations. As I said before, I want to add a node annotation on button click. So I add the event click with the callback method add annotations. I define the callback method here to include the add logic. To add an annotation with a button click, I need to access the diagram's built-in method. So I add the diagram reference. To create the reference, I first import the view child from the Angular core package. Then define a variable diagram object. And then use the view child directive to create the diagram instance. Note that this diagram component is imported from the Syncfusion ej2 Angular diagrams package. Using the diagram instance, I call the addLabels method. And pass the fifth node object from the nodes collection. And pass the annotation content, odd number, as parameters based on shape annotation model. At last, I call the DataBind method to apply changes to the component. In the app component CSS file, add the margin style for the button to align it. When I click the button, annotation content will be added to the fifth node. To explain other features with clarity, I uncomment this annotation content.
you can customize the note annotations dynamically by adding another button with a click event. Then change the click event method name and content as update annotations.
I defined the callback method here to include the update logic.
Here, I can change annotation content or style. Now I plan to change the annotation position using the offset property based on fractions.
Look at this image, it represents different offset values in which the note annotations can be positioned.
0 represents top left corner, 1 represents bottom right corner, and 0.5 represents half of width and height.
I get the second node from the nodes collection and define the annotation offset with x and y values as 0,0, which means annotation will be shown at the top right corner of the second node. This shape annotation model class is imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. At last, I call the DataBind method to apply changes to the component.
When the Update Annotations button is clicked, the second node annotation is aligned based on the offset property. You can also align the node annotation horizontally and vertically.
By default, it is displayed at the center. That is, node annotations are at the center for both horizontal and vertical alignments. Apart from this default alignment, it also supports all the combination values of left, right, top, bottom, and center. Now, I will demonstrate the left, top alignment by setting horizontal alignment to left and vertical alignment to top.
When I click the Update Annotations button, you can see the annotation aligned at the top left position with respect to the current offset value. This flowchart contains a condition that returns either true or false.
To make the flowchart clearer, I will add annotations to the connectors as well.
Similar to the node, you can add the annotation by double-clicking the connector.
Within the third connector, I add the eConnector annotations tag to define the annotation collection.
And in it add eConnector annotation tag and set the content to true. In the same way, I add the annotation content to false to the fourth connector. Now, the annotations have been added to the specified connectors. I'll also demonstrate how to customize the alignment of connector annotations. By default, they are displayed at the center, but I can change it to before or after alignments. To the false content connector, I add the alignment property and set its value to before. And for the true content connector, set the alignment to after.
Check now, connectors are aligned based on the specified alignments.
You can also position the connector annotation based on three offset values. The value 0 represents the top left corner, 1 represents the bottom right corner, and 0.5 represents half of the height or width.
Now in the fourth connector, I set the offset property value to 1. Look here, the fourth connector annotation position is updated based on the provided offset value. To explain other features with clarity, I'll remove this offset property.
Notice the annotations are very close to the connectors.
To further adjust the position of an annotation from its current location, use the displacement property. To add more space between them, I declare the variable displacement
and define its x-axis and y-axis values to 10 pixels.
Assign this variable to the displacement property of the third and fourth connector annotations.
Here the connector annotations are displayed based on the specified position.
You can also change the display direction of connector annotations based on the segment direction. To do that, I add the segment angle property and set its value to true for the third connector. Looking here, the annotation is rotated based on the direction of the third connector segment. Next, I will display a hyperlink on a node annotation using the hyperlink property. I declare a variable hyperlink. Define the content as Syncfusion angular diagram and set the diagram FT page path to the link property. Assign this variable to the hyperlink property of the first node annotation and remove the content property since I have provided the content in the hyperlink settings. Check now, the hyperlink is added to the first node annotation. Click the annotation text to navigate to the page linked. By default, the annotation wraps when it overflows the node's width to avoid displaying broken words. This type is wrap with overflow. The other options available are wrap and no wrap. The wrap option breaks the word if needed, while the no wrap option prevents the text from being wrapped. You can define how the text should be wrapped using text wrapping property. I define the text style of type object and set the text wrapping property to wrap option. Additionally, modify the hyperlink content to end with the word component. Assign this variable to the style property of the first node annotation. See the output, the first node content is wrapped. Finally, I'll show you how to customize the annotation font styles. In the text style variable, set the color as orange and enable the bold property. Also, I remove the hyperlink property to show the font customization with clarity and set the content as start. Now, the font styles of the first node annotation are customized. In this video, you have learned how to add annotations to nodes and connectors programmatically and dynamically. You have also seen how to align and position the annotations using different properties like offset, horizontal alignment, vertical alignment, hyperlink, and more. Additionally, you have learned how to customize the appearance of the annotation by setting text wrapping and font styles. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.